Hey, Woodstock back again. I hope everyone's doing okay. And hope they had a Merry Christmas and Happy New Year's coming up here too as well. Just kind of chilling, working on some new piece here. A little different. Trying some different stuff here. I sped things up to spare you guys the agony of sitting through this thing. It is about a 2-hour project or more, somewhere around that. 2 hours, maybe 2.5. But anyway, got down to 10 minutes. Again, this is another pine knot, which I'm working on to do this face. Comes from the Cascade range again. And it's a pretty nice piece, I think. Not too scabby or cracky or anything like that. So, yeah, turns out pretty well, most part, if you find them, kind of analyze them before you start carving them. So sometimes you get some hollow ones that are not good, though. So it's like hit or miss sometimes. Yeah, anyway, if you guys are interested, I got a rundown of my bit list at the end of the video, if you want to check it out. I got all the numbers and the sizes if you're interested. I tend to use the really small engraver bits for detail work and stuff like that. So, yeah, by all means, sit through the video if you want, or go skip to the end if you want to see what I'm using. Doesn't matter. It's all good. Yeah, back with the Stylo Plus from Dremel. Shit, this stuff's getting cheap. I saw one in the store the other day. I think it was Menards. Yeah, it was Menards. But anyway, it's like a lot cheaper than it is. It's about $40 now, dropping in price. It was $50 at Home Depot. So, yeah, it's a... I can't believe how cheap those things are. They last a little longer too. I mean, no problems whatsoever now. Yeah, I'm not trying to push it on anyone. I'm not a spokesperson for this company at all, but when something works really well, I'll mention it over and over again just to, you know, in case someone misses it the first time when I mentioned it in earlier videos. But yeah, it's pretty affordable, economical, and reliable, all in the same package, I'd say, you know. Yeah, there was kind of a delay in putting this video up for, I could have got it up earlier, but downloaded some new software for editing called LumaFusion, and that's the reason why there was a slight delay in this video upload. So anyway, but now I finally got it uploaded, and I'm very excited about the software that I'm using because it's a lot easier and has a lot more features than what I was using before as a cheesy iMovie on iPhone. But now I'm upgraded, so it's a little better now. I mean, for video quality and stuff like that, I'd say. Yeah, this face I'm working on, it's a little different from my normal style. Actually showing more eyes this time instead of a squint look, you know, and then showing some teeth. They're kind of nasty looking teeth, like he didn't have proper dental care or something like that. So, but give it more character. try not to do the same thing repeatedly. I try to like branch off and try different things. I think it gives your collection a lot more variety, per se. Yeah, I'm using this old school owl. It's like, I think, a leather tool for punching holes in leather, but this is my grandfather's, and I decided to use it in a different way. Use it for woodworking, scribing, and burnishing. It seems to work well. And yeah, any tool you can get your hands on, use it by all means. You never know what you're gonna find. Yeah, I tend to use smaller bits quite often. It gives me a lot more control as opposed to like a bigger bit where you're taking tons of material off. And this way, when you use a smaller bit, you can selectively remove material to achieve your desired results. That's the reason why I do it. Yeah, this process may take a bit longer, but you know, I'm not into speed carving or anything like that, you know, trying to pump out shit tons of wood spirits, you know. Just kind of chill, relax, have fun, carve, drink a beer, whatever, smoke a cig, whatever gets you through the day, you know. Yeah, I decided to give this guy a sideways glance look. He's looking off to his left at something with a smile on his face, showing his like nasty little teeth. It's all part of the character. Gives it like a personality in a way. So yeah, we're coming up on the end of the video. Hope you guys enjoyed this one. If you guys have any questions or comments, I'm always, I'll be happy to answer any questions you have in the comment section or via email. Anyway, thanks again for stopping by, and I'll see you guys later.